GMA germ alert that may have you thinking twice before you wear your shoes in the house again. We tested the bottoms of people's shoes for bacteria. Well, actually, GMA consumer correspondent Elizabeth Leamy did, and she joins us now from Washington. All right, yes, last week lemons, now this. Okay, Elizabeth.
Uh-huh, and once again, get ready to say, ew! We persuaded 8 people to let us to bare their soles for us, basically, yes, the soles of their shoes. We also tested a couple of dogs' paws, just for fun, and what we found has me thinking about some changes here at my house.
The gifts go over on the table, and the shoes go there.
In this classic Sex and the City scene, Carrie Bradshaw is stunned when asked to leave her fabulous shoes at the door.
Here, Aunt Chuck don't like outside dirt coming in. The twins are always picking things up off the floor.
After all, unlike in other countries, most Americans wear their shoes in the house, including Mom Michelle Chocon.
I don't really think that much about it.
Maybe she should. We took 10 swabs from a variety of people and pets, and Michelle's shoes contained the most bacteria of all. Off the charts with 66 million organisms. It's no reflection on her. Probably means she stepped directly in something.
Remove the bacteria by just rubbing the swab.
In a recent study, researchers at the University of Arizona found 9 different species of bacteria on people's shoes. Bacteria that can cause infections in our stomachs, eyes, lungs, and more.
These are way dirtier than toilet seats. Toilet seats generally have 1,000 bacteria or less, and these are in the millions. So there's a lot more bacteria here.
Worse yet, the study found bacteria lives longer on our shoes than in other places, because as we walk, we constantly pick up new debris that feeds it. The researchers also tested to see if that bacteria would transfer to the tile floors in a house. And it did, more than 90% of the time. Carpeting is even worse.
I'm concerned. I'm going to make sure everyone takes their shoes off from now on.
Children under age 2 are the most vulnerable to the stuff we track in, since they play on the floor and put their hands in their mouths an average of 80 times an hour, which hits home at my house with 1.5-year-old Kelsey.
That means that your child can possibly be exposed to every single bacteria that you walked around and picked up on your shoe. All the bacteria from the park, from the stores, from everywhere you went that day.
My own sneakers were the second worst in our test, with 31 million bacteria.
Absolutely.
So since we typically interview people and get their reactions for a story like this, here goes.
Were you surprised that there was so much bacteria on your shoes? I was. I consider having to take my shoes off when I come in the house sort of an aggravation, because I'm always in such a rush, but I have to tell you, I'm going to reconsider.
Out of our 10 tests, 9 contained coliform, a type of bacteria that comes mostly from, well, human and animal waste. Scientists blame the floors of public restrooms and bird and dog droppings. So how did the dogs do in our bacteria test? Not bad. Their paws came in 5th and 9th.
So if you don't want to have a pile of shoes or a shoe rack at your door, one thing you can do is just take your shoes off at the door and then carry them to your closet, where the bacteria will die in 1 to 3 days. Of course, that means you're going to have to wash your hands, but that's not a bad idea anytime you come home anyway, Robin.
Well, Sybil, I mean, Elizabeth, let me ask you one question as you interview yourself there. You're in your own home. Do you ask your guests to remove their shoes, and what's the etiquette for doing that?
Oh gosh, I have not done that in the past. I'm now reconsidering the etiquette. We actually consulted 4 experts, and they said it's okay to ask your guests to do that, but they suggested you have clean slippers or socks, something like that, to make them comfortable. And if you're having a big party, skip it.
Yeah, and let them know, women know, so they can get a pedicure ahead of time if you're going to do that. Thanks, Elizabeth. Thanks for letting us come into your home. We appreciate it. You can find out more on our website at abcnews.com. I know lots of folks, they log on and say, hey, what's a little dirt? What's little germs?
Right.
It helps your immune system.
Now you know, though.
Now you do know.
In a flash, be the first to know what's coming up on Good Morning America tomorrow with the GMA Daily Flash email. All the great insider details you want to know from GMA. Go to abcnews.com, click the GMA page, and sign up for the Daily Flash. And you can even enter to win the weekly GMA Flash gift bag giveaway. Sign up now.